Greetings dear friends, I present your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the Mercedes-Benz GL-Klasse X164. Most modern Mercedes-Benz cars are painted, to be honest, quite mediocre. But there are also happy exceptions in the face of the S-Class W221, the comparatively good GLK X204, or today's patient GL X164. These cars, even at the age of 10, usually have a very good paintwork condition and a minimum of purely age-related damage. The layers of paint and varnish, with an average thickness of 100 microns, lose a little in brightness, the plastic of the headlights is rubber off, and the windshield is no longer happy with perfect transparency, the bumpers are gradually peeling off, but the metal of the body is doing well. Moreover, even in areas with high humidity, for example in the niche under the windshield, in the trunk, under the bumpers and in the lower part of the doors, everything is usually fine. Of course, there are exceptions, and most often these cars that have plowed the roads of Moscow and St. Petersburg from birth. Since the quality of the metal is quite high, then if a problem is detected in time, moisture and main fossae are removed, corrosion can be stopped for some more time. In any case, it breaks not only when the machine is left to drift and in all the meanings. In this case, it is worth paying attention to the loaded seams of the bulkhead of the engine compartment, suspension glasses and the windshield niche. In the case of sewage pollution and poor maintenance in this area, the most unpleasant damages are possible, in the presence of which it is already worth abandoning the purchase altogether. Slight corrosion in the area of attachment of the subframes, behind the shields of filters and tubes on the bottom is typical for off-road vehicles. On examination, I recommend that you look inside the bottom side members. Their dirt can do a lot more things. Fortunately, due to the peculiarities of the operation of the air suspension, GL is often washed from below, and this has good effect on the condition of the body, especially in the rear. By the way, you need to be careful with the sink. An inaccurately directed jet from the car hair can flood the trunk and the rear SAM unit through the underground ventilation system. Of course, the main fault for flooding still lies with the leakage of the upper opening of the rear door and manual condensation in the luggage compartment, but cases of water appearing precisely after washing and precisely through the ventilation system are reliably known. The back door on the GL is almost always equipped with an electric drive, and the drive system is neither faultless nor healthy. The already mentioned water in the trunk can cause a malfunction of its drive. Purely mechanical problems are still often encountered in it. The gears of the mechanism cuts off, the gearbox case breaks. Mechanical difficulties can be expected by 120-150,000 km of urban operation, and even more often in traveling cars. As with any premium crossover, you should pay attention to the condition of the external plastic parts, because the price of a nonsense part can be shocking. Some of the small things can be inexpensive, but most of them seem to be made of pure plastic gold with iridium coating. Bumpers, linings and anthers can be compared at a price to serious body repair, and there are not so many non-original parts. In any case, you will have to try to get them in Russia, and they damaged them quite easily. On such machines, they often climb curbs and park on top of hemispheres limiters, not to mention off-road driving. Small rubbing on the bumper is already a reason to carefully examine the fastening elements on the fog lamps, parking sensors, which are very low, wiring and anthers from the bottom. The bumper cover can play, and the fastening of various elements can be damaged, providing the owner with a headache for many years. All this is especially true for thrifty buyers who take GL Klasse for less than a million. Prices are valid for December 2016. These are all, as a rule, unkempt cars, which even with the tolerable condition of the motors are boxes, and boxes can have a million minor breakdowns. If you take a car for a price of less than a million, then this should be expected, because even with a good condition in the engine and automatic transmission, there are many minor troubles and ideal copies are rated higher. The headlights will almost certainly be badly worn out, although this can be relatively easily treated by polishing. The main thing is not to forget to stick the film after. The headlight mechanics are gradually wearing out, and even the tightness of the front optics is lost with age. Surprisingly, the price tag is quite sparing, especially against the background of competitors, and you can replace the entire headlight. A worn windshield is also inexpensive, thanks to the American assembly. I'll tell you a secret that sometime something can be ordered from eBay and American production cheaper than from China. The same plastic can cost less than a fortune, but about one-fifth. The corrosion resistance of the air conditioner radiators leaves much to be desired. With our road cocktail, after 5 to 6 years, the metal already becomes brittle and loses a substantial part of the cooling area. The air conditioner pipes to the rear evaporator also over corrode. and the price of new ones as more than 25,000 rubles. Numerous connections of long lines also flow, and the air conditioner compressor is very capricious. If you stubbornly operate the machine with low but not yet emergency pressure in the system, it will fail, and the price of the original part is from 70,000 rubles. Corrosion in the wiper trapezium joints here is the same as on the W211 and Audi Q7. The combination of materials is equally unfortunate. True, the car is higher, less dirt gets into this zone, the compaction is a little better. And the problem is not so common, but when buying it, it is worth turning on the wipers and assessing the ease of movement. I will not write about the prices for spare parts again, they are consistently high. Of the other little things that can potentially spoil the pleasure of buying, we can recall the not very successful design of the exhaust system. It loses its fasteners and there are shocks and vibrations from below. Do not rush to sort out the suspension in the presence of unnecessary noise. In general, periodically increased noise and knocking of the structure is one of the serious shortcomings of the 164 bodies, but here most of the blame lies with the transmission and suspension. The interior is a delight for the eyes and hands, in any case, if you do not find fault too much. It's really not bad here by any measure, only more demanding European buyers would like richer materials for this price. Well, or at least matching the command panels and the climate to the interior color in all variants, not just in gray ones. And also more accurate seams, threads, and so on. It is clear that to the owner of an average Skoda Octavia, this already seems outright snobbery, but the person who buys a car for 6 million is counting on exclusive quality, at least in the visible part. And if Gelandewagen is forgiven a lot for the legendary name, including easily detectable flaws in the manual assembly of the interior, then with GL there were enough claims to fill up the image in due time. The price of the car turned out to be much higher than that of the ML, with practically the same interior and equipment, and comparison with all Mercedes models played a role. Now the interior of the same of the new S-Klasse W222 seems to be excellent, with many W140 owners managed to find cheapness in it and quite decently argued the point of view. Don't laugh, but the discrepancy between the texture of the wood on the center console and the doors for many is a reason for serious criticism, and the delimitation of the lock here on the door inserts and on the panel next to, I wanted to say automatic transmission lever, but here it is on the steering column, and on the central tunnel there are only cup holders and a box for small things. So the delimitation of the varnish next to the cup holders is already a reason for frustration. Insufficient metal inserts in the deflectors, non-predictable movement of the air flow direction flaps, and even the rapid wear of the pedal pads was also one of the serious complaints. The difficulties are about the same as on the other cars of the brand. Sometimes peeling and breaking off panels, quickly worn out leather of the steering wheel and the driver's seats, heavily soiled cloth fabric. Visible interior wear or pollution most likely indicates that the car's mileage is well over 200,000, or a service car from among those about the internal components of which they do not really care. For example, an auto escort or a transfer from a country hotel. Separately, it is worth talking about an important element of preserving the appearance of the cabin, the air filter. There are two of them here at once, and for replacement it is not necessary to remove the glove box, as written in the manual. With some skill, they can be changed from under the hood, and it is recommended to do this as often as possible, especially if the interior is light. But a very common misfortune of the 100 to 1.5 hundred mileage associated with the failure of the main evaporator valve is not only 50,000 for a new part, but also at least half of this amount for removing and installing the dashboard. If the rear row of seats doesn't receive enough airflow, first check the integrity of the fuses and the regulator of the second climate system fan. Yes, there is a second stove, as in the Gazelle, only with air conditioning, and it is not under the seat, but in the depths of the developed center console. The volume of the luggage compartment is the absence of a third row of seats is impressive. To reach the edge, you need to get into it. It is not for nothing that among the branded accessories, there is a mat with which you can cover the bumper or comfortably kneel on it during loading operations. Some machines even have an optional rollout pallet. But a full-fledged acoustic shelf cannot be ordered, so any noise from leaks in the rear door easily penetrates into the interior. With all rows of seats folded, the floor is absolutely flat, without steps, and the length of the berth is more than 2 meters, and the hay allows you to stay more comfortable than in a tent. Collective farming with Mercedes-Benz owners is not in vogue, but they are still engaged in tuning the multimedia system, and they are trying to introduce design elements from the more modern GLS class. Most often, there are elements responsible for interfacing with modern smartphones and tablets for displaying video on displays in the headrests and for high-quality sound. The car is often taken as a family car. It also goes to small accessories such as door lock pillars, door sills, floor mats, less often the steering wheels and seats, which are changed to AMG or to more recent ones. On the electrical side, everything is not as smooth as with the interior, although there are generally few complaints about the workmanship, the location of the rear SEM unit, and the general layout of the wiring make one think that the car was made exclusively for movement in sunny California. I already mentioned the weather in the rear compartment. It can get here in many ways, from direct ingress into the technical compartment of the trunk, through the ventilation to the formation of condensation or moisture penetration, through the back door due to the failure of its mechanism or banal wear of the seal, or a broken washer tube. By the way, what is the SAM block? The name is in the abbreviation for the German Signal Auswerte module, that is, Intelligent Power Management and Signal Transmission Unit. There are two of them on Mercedes-Benz cars, front and rear, that together they provide the work of almost all electronics. Through them, various electronic units of the machine can be turned on, off, and controlled by other units. In the event of a failure or simply a failure of this module, various troubles are possible, from a quick landing of the battery to an increased load on the generator due to the inclusion of unnecessary systems at the moment to the failure of a number of elements. In the case of the GL-Klasse X164, it is usually the rear SAM that suffers. It all starts with faults in the radio channel of the key fob, failure of the rear door drives, rear lighting devices, and then fuel level indicators, windshield wipers, parking sensors, and partly the multimedia system fail. If you ignore the failures and reset the power, then the problems will progress. The price of replacing a block now is at least 50,000 rubles, but this is necessary only in really advanced cases. SAM know how to repair well, and at the first sign of trouble, it is enough to dry it off after washing with alcohol, remove oxidized, and restore soldering disturbances and damage to contact groups. Inaccurate dry cleaning threatens not only this SAM unit, but also the wiring of the passenger compartment, the common harness, and the wiring to the fuel pump. In the trunk, it is risk zone. In the risk zone, there are parking sensors, a rear differential lock, a control unit for the third row of seats and the rear door, as well as the body acceleration sensors. In the passenger compartment, on the passenger side, the control units for the multimedia system and the transfer keys are under attack. On the driver's side, the comfort unit, air suspension control, and others. It is probably not worth reminding that it is better to keep the window closed, especially the rear ones. Trivial rain can cause losses in the hundreds of thousands. However, even in the driest cabin, the SAM unit can be irrevocably destroyed. For example, it is enough to put the main battery in the case of a faulty auxiliary battery and unsuccessfully light up. Yes, there are two batteries, the second is responsible for emergency power supply to the automatic transmission control unit, and the rear SAM with an access system. Moreover, the battery is exactly the same as in a regular uninterruptible power supply unit, 12 volts and 1.2, but the original cost at least 7,000 rubles, and not 700 as an ordinary household one. In case of serviceability of additional battery, it is still not recommended to light up. Other cars, if really necessary, can only be lit when the engine is completely turned off and there is no key in the ignition lock. Better yet, don't do it at all. This is exactly the case when the risk is great and not worth it. Sophisticated electronics are afraid not only of water but also of the heat in the engine compartment. For example, the control unit for gasoline engines M273 is at risk. It is recommended to wash its ripped cover regularly and monitor the tightness of the case. Corrosion has also not been cancelled. In the case of installing turning firmware, the block case can be filled to access the board. In this case, the risks are even higher. The OM642 diesel engine glow control unit is also afraid of something. In this case, its early versions failed regularly. Check when buying. There should be a part with the number A642-900-5701. The earlier ones are unstable. The candles themselves traditionally boil. Periodic preventive removal and installation is recommended. If you start the situation, then a banal hit for aid is no longer enough. You will need special equipment and specially sealed services can even damage the cylinder head, removing it with improvised mends. In general, the power supply systems for motors are far from ideal. In addition to the glow control unit and the spark plugs, the diesel engine has injectors, a valve and a pressure sensor in the fuel rail, as well as a turbine servo drive in the risk zone. Gasoline engines fail mainly temperature and oil level sensors, as well as fans and their power circuit, plus the electronic thermostat fails. It is strongly discouraged to wash the engine compartment from the car hair with any engine. At least you can damage the wiring, the front SAM and the relay and the fuse box. Otherwise, the electrician has quite Mercedes reliability. no worse than that of other cars of the brand. The more expensive the equipment is, the greater the number of wear parts, and there are simply no empty cars. So the number of failures is generally higher than that of the empty ML-W164. On machines of the first releases, you can count on periodic spending of these parts, for the most fresh expenses of this kind are unlikely, mainly force majeure and problems associated with unsuccessful interventions in the wiring. While the recommendation not to take specially neglected and set locking options even at the most attractive price, albeit banal, it is very relevant. And this information about the problems of the Mercedes-Benz GL-Klasse X164 is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I'm waiting for you in the comments.